Good morning, students. Myself Kamal Nath. You all are welcome in the class of grammar. Student, this week we are learning clause. And in the last part of the video session, you all studied and learned what is clause and what is noun clause. The first clause you have already learned, that has been explained. It is second video. And in this video, I am going to explain you, I am going to teach you adjective clause. So, you please listen and learn what is adjective clause, what are its functions, what are its uses. And with that, I will include you one exercise from the chapter also. So, let's start with clause, that is adjective clause. What is adjective clause? A clause that functions like an adjective in a sentence is called an adjective clause. A clause that functions like an adjective in a sentence is called an adjective clause. The boy who is standing in the corner is my brother. You can see in this sentence, who is standing in the corner. This is clause and this is adjective clause. This part is adjective clause. The boy who is standing in the corner is my brother. So, who is standing in the corner is adjective clause. The pen which I lost yesterday. The pen which I lost yesterday is very costly. In this sentence, which I lost yesterday is adjective clause. It's a clause, you know, because it has a subject and verb. It has a subject and verb. Although it is not making complete meaning, complete sense, that's why it is called clause. It has to depend on another part of the sentence to complete its meaning. That's why it is called clause. The pen which I lost yesterday is very costly. You ask a question. What is costly? The pen. The pen. Okay. That is costly, which I lost yesterday. So, which I lost yesterday is a clause because it is not making complete meaning, complete sense in itself. And that's why it is called clause. The lady whom you talked right now is a teacher. The lady whom you talked right now is a teacher. In this sentence, whom you talked right now is clause. It has subject and finite verb both. You is subject, talked is finite verb. But it is not making complete meaning, complete sense, because it has to depend on the rest part of the sentence, other part of the sentence to complete its meaning. So, let us see next example. The bag which is kept, it is here, is a spelling, will be here, is, my dear, it's a mistake here. The bag which is kept on the table is mine. So here, which is kept on the table is clause. Let us see here, forms of adjective clauses. Forms of adjective clauses. And adjective clauses tells something about the noun in the sentence. The book which is in your hand is mine. The book which is in your hand is mine. The painting which you have made is very attractive. So you can see here, adjective clauses. The book which is in your hand is adjective clause. The painting which you have made is here adjective clause. Let us see here, made is very attractive. That was it here, made is very attractive. Let us see our next, be. An adjective clause begins with a relative pronoun. An adjective clause begins with a relative pronoun like who, whom, whose, that or which. These are relative pronoun and adjective clause start with this relative pronouns, or it also start with a relative adverb like when, where or why. You see some examples. I will come when you call me. I will come when you call me. Now I understand why he has gone early. Now I understand why he has gone early. So you can see here, when you call me, why he has gone early. So these are here adjective clauses. An adjective clause answers the question which or who. Which or who. You can see example. This is the man who helped me. The book which I lost yesterday has been found. So very clear. Whatever the rules tells you, the examples you can see and match with them. You have exercise C here. You can see underline the adjective clauses in these sentences that I have already done. In these all sentences, I have underlined adjective clauses. Here is the novel that you wanted. Here is the novel that you wanted. That you wanted is an adjective clause. Those who do not complain are never pitied. Grandfather remembers the old days when there was no television. Eco-friendly cars that run on electricity save gas. Fast food, which most people love, is not good for our health. All the underlined parts in all sentences are adjective clause. Mr. Rao is the teacher who helped me understand the basics of maths. This is the park which is meant for community functions. This is the park which is meant for community functions. So which is meant for community functions is adjective clause. This is the park. Okay, next one. This is the park where people take their pets for a walk. So where people take their pets for a walk is adjective clause. That young boy who broke the window pane is here. So in this part, who broke the window pane is adjective clause. You have to tell here, this is the part of warm up. You can see warm up. You have to tell whether these group of words are sentences or phrase or clauses. You have already read sentence, you have already read phrase before this, and then the clause you are reading. You know what is clause. So you have to read this group of words and then you have to determine whether this group of words are clause, sentence or phrase. What do you plan to do today? It is clear. This group of words makes complete sense. And so this is a sentence, not clause, nor phrase. If it doesn't rain, it is a clause because it has subject and it has a finite verb. It doesn't make complete sense and that's why it's not sentence, but it is a clause. The sunflowers in the field, it is a phrase. It is group of words. It makes a little sense, but not complete sense. So it is a phrase. What is close to our hive? It is clause. My friend, it is phrase. Who stays in the park hive? Clause. It is clause. Has invited me. Phrase. The child has a toy which is made of metal. It is sentence because it makes complete sense. Complete meaning. A metallic toy. It's a group of words. But it is not making sense. And as it has no subject, no verb, So it is neither a clause nor a sentence. It's a phrase. Unless you run fast, very fast, that is clause. It has subject and it has verb. You is subject, run is verb. And that's why it is a clause. It doesn't make complete sense. And that's why it's clause. When you set back from the trip, it is also a clause. Catch a cold, it's a phrase. So, this was what? Adjective clause. And you read about its functions, its uses, in which forms they are used in the sentence. And we have discussed here warm up, one exercise. You all will do these all what is explained right now in your copy and learn them nicely. Thank you. Thank you, student, being with me and watching.